Hi, this is Eric Martin with Board Game Geek. I'll be looking today at Monster My Neighbor, designed by Pesu Nabeno and published by Korea Board Games, with Z-Man Games also doing a separate edition of this hidden role game for 3 to 8 players, in which each of the 5 rounds, one player is going to have a monster card among the cards in their hand, and at least one other player is going to have a hunter. Obviously, you can guess where this is going. The hunter is trying to find the monster. The player with the monster does not want the monster to be found because you're a decent human being who wants to protect your monsters as if they were people as well. It makes sense. The monsters might go traveling and go end up in different people's hands as they move around the table, so your role in the game may change over time. How does it work? Here are the components in Monster My Neighbor. You have 5 monster cards, one monster for each round, and you will choose a monster at random. You shuffle those, you add one to the deck for that round. The deck will also start with a starting player card. If you end up with this in your starting hand, you just put it down in front of you. Next player in clockwise order it goes. Okay. You have one hunter and one hide. The hunter is trying to find the monster. So you accuse someone, you have the monster. If they do, they put it down in front of them. You get 2 points. Everyone else who's not a monster and not a friend gets a point. Okay, and then you start a new round. However, the deck also has at least one hide card. And if someone has the monster and the hide, you just, do you have the monster? No, I don't have the monster. Okay, the hide has done its job. Once the hide is down in front of you, it does not help you anymore. You are not hidden. All right. So you have these 3 starting cards, you take a monster at random, and you also take 4 more cards per player minus 1, because here's 4 cards, so in a 4-player game, you're going to have 16 cards. You take those cards, you shuffle them up, you throw them around the table, and then you give 4 cards per person. Okay, and proceed with the game. Here, the starting player. I'm going to play this rumor card, where everyone grabs a card from the player to the right. Maybe I don't have something interesting, so I'm going to hope, and you do that all simultaneously. Okay. I have a fog, which is, each of us takes a card, we put them in the middle of the table, and we deal 1 card out to each player again. All right. There are cards that let you trade cards with other people. You can steal a card from another person, give them back a card of your choice. There are additional hunters. There are other hides. There is a dog who's trying to sniff out the monster. You go up to someone and say, do you have the monster? Hide doesn't help. Dog senses are much better than human senses. Do you have the monster? If you do, you're out. If not, you take a card of your choice, put it face down in front of that player, play the dog, and the dog goes in your hand. The dog will hunt again, trying to find it. If you have a friend, you're trying to protect the monster, all right? Goth girls always want to protect those that are less loved, they're outcasts from society. Okay, maybe it's a stereotype, but it's true. Okay, so you accuse someone. Do you have a hunter? If they do, they have to discard that card and draw a replacement. And now if the monster wins, you win. Okay, you've got other cards. Villagers, they do nothing. They're useless. Sorry. Rumors, you're going to pass cards. Gossip, pass cards. Investigate, look at someone's hand. All right. Each person is going to play 1 card at a time in each round. Hunters cannot be played in the first round, so you're going to get some information first by some looking at things or trading or seeing what cards move where. Okay. Monsters can be played only in the last round, so you have to last until the end of until your turn on the 4th round, and then you can put your monster down and win. Except sometimes monsters have special conditions that can get them out earlier. Okay. This can be played if 2 villagers have been played. As soon as those are done, doom. This one can be played if 2 hunters have been played. All right. This one, the first hunter has no effect on you. All right. You're just like, what? I don't know what you're talking about. It's a built-in hide, but only for the first hunter. And this card here, the hunters do not work if this is the final card in your hand. So hunters better get shooting quickly. All right. Which you can waste hunters as well if you have them in your hand. It's a way to protect yourself. Very clever. Unless, of course, this card gets passed to someone else, and then you're toast. So you finish a round, you're going to get points, you pull out the start card, a different monster, a hide and a hunter, Yeah, shuffle up the deck again, you add four more cards, and you go again for five rounds.
And there's a run through of Monster My Neighbor, which I've played six or seven times now, twice on a Finnish press copy from Korea Board Games, and four or five times in prototype form, mostly in the back room of the Korea Board Games booth at Spiel 2014, where they wanted to show me the game in advance. We just had a little playtest sheets of paper on magic cards and sleeves, you know, the usual rigmarole that you do for prototypes. And we played, and I asked to play again, and we played again, and we played again. It was, all right. It was a good experience there. It was one of the few games I actually play at Spiel, and of course, it's a prototype for something coming out a year later. What you gonna do? All right. So I played with 4, 5, 6, and 8 players. The player range is 3 to 8. The game changes a lot depending on how many players are in the game, because with more players, you have more cards. With 8 players, you have almost all the cards, not quite. So you have more hunters in play. It makes it much tougher for the monster to survive. You have greater reward if you do, because of course only the monster scores points, along with friends getting a point each, and that's a smaller number of the group that score versus the hunter winning, with all the non-friends and non-monsters winning. So if you want to put some distance between you and the other players, you can take that chance. With 4 players, it's a lot easier for the monster to win, because there's just fewer people who are going to be shooting at you. Alright, so this affects what you do as you pass cards along. Once you know it's tough, you pass things along or not, depending on what sort of information you think that will give you later in the game. As you know, I passed it here, da, da, da. We did a fog after that. I don't know exactly where it ended up, but you went to the friend and blah, blah, blah. All the usual stuff in hidden deduction games that go on. There's a callback to Love Letter naturally, just with this type of game. You're trying to deduce what people are and suss out what they're doing, why they might be doing this or that. Okay, but the game lasts a little longer than Love Letter because, of course, there's more than 16 cards. And there's multiple rounds where you're sort of playing off each other. You have choices on what you're going to do with the cards in your hand. Everything is very dynamic in terms of cards changing owners. And you got these temporary alliances that come up when someone is a friend and you got the monster. Okay, how else have they acted? Is there any way to cue them in as to what you have without getting killed? Probably not, but I don't know. Maybe I just haven't played enough times yet. All right, there you go. So you're going to play 5 rounds with each monster once, and you totally up your points, and you're like, oh yeah, you won. All right, whatever. You can just play again.